Right, so for the first Lamy Learns, I wanted to talk about this. These, as I've got a lot of them, are available on Amazon. They're about £20. There's a link in the description. And they're what you call RGB LED Parcans, or just lights. They're about 40 watts. And if you search for LED Parcan on Amazon, you'll find lots of these things. And what they've got is they've got like a cluster of, you see these red, green and blue LEDs, and it's repeated all around the face. And the idea is, what it's doing at the moment is just cycling through different intensities of those colours. If I have a look, you can have a look on the wall here. There you go, just to show what it outputs. So you get a very nice mixture of colours that go from blue, purple to red. I mean, it's not very good at the oranges and yellows, to be honest. But there's a green in there as well. Again, for £20, you don't get CMY colour mixing or anything fancy here. But you can see it can put out a various range of colours. And that's what I use across my backdrop on my videos. So here's the interesting thing about these. They're only £20. And they have something called DMX. And that's what I'm going to talk about, because DMX allows you to use a computer to control all manner of lighting equipment. This isn't a tutorial for lighting professionals who will know all this. It's elementary stuff, really. But it's for streamers who don't know this. I'm going to show you very cheap and effective ways to use this technology. So you'll need something like this. Now, you can tell if something is able to be controlled by DMX by, if we have a look on the back, you shall see, let's bring some light in there, what looks to be there microphone sockets, right? XLR 3-pin, but they are not. It actually says there, if you can see that, it says DMX out and DMX in. So that's what you're looking for. Anything with these, you'll see what looks like a male and a female microphone slot, although it's not a sort of socket. But that's what we use to connect up our DMX signals to the computer. And the reason it's got an out and an in is you connect the computer to your in, and then your out can connect to another light and another light and another, and you can form up a whole chain of lights, and you can control them all individually and get them to do all sorts of things. You can also control smoke machines and special effects and all sorts, all using one long string of DMX. So there you go. So the other thing you need, I say connect it to your computer. How do you connect it to your computer? You go on Amazon again, or you can find these in other places, but Amazon's the cheapest way to do this. And you buy one of these. Big old cable. And this cable has two things. Now, this is an unusual looking cable if you know cables. Let me up the light for you 1 second. So this cable has two things on it. One end is a very long cable, which is useful because you want your lights to be a long way away. But on one end, it has USB. Normal sort of standard USB plug. Nothing fancy. On the other end, it has what looks like a microphone plug. Again, you see there, three pins. Do not plug this into a microphone. That's not what it's for. So here's the thing. DMX used to use a 5-pin connector. And somewhere along the lines, we decided that, well, it's easier if we could use our microphone cables. So they came out with a 3-pin connector. It is exactly the same as a microphone cable. In fact, if you've got microphone cables, they will work. Now, that's not professional. It's not the right way to do it, but it will work. You can buy special DMX cables. They're electrically slightly different, but their work is microphone leads and vice versa. But what you don't do is you don't plug that into the microphone. So this end goes into your computer, your USB. And this will go into that DMX in. If we get it the right way in. There we go. So now I can take the other end and I can plug it in to my PC. I've got a little USB hub here. I can plug it in there. And now, through the power of software, I am able to take full control over this device. Now, let me tell you a little bit more about DMX just before I do. So the way DMX works, if you're familiar with MIDI, it works very much like MIDI does, only in reverse. So in MIDI, you have like a keyboard or something, you play your keyboard, and it sends signal to the computer, and the computer decides what notes to play. Well, on this, the computer sends signals to the light to tell it what color to be, or to how bright to be, or where to move its mirrors and things like that. And the way it does it is it uses what we call DMX channels. And a channel is essentially just like a fader on a mixing desk or a knob. It's a control that goes from 0 to 127. But we could imagine that as being 0 to 100%, but that's the number for computer reasons. So if we were to set this to 0, it would be off, for example, and 127 would be fully bright and a variation in between. So this device here has multiple DMX channels, and most devices do. So we can control the overall intensity, or we can control just the red, or just the green, or just the blue. And to do that, we need to use a special piece of software. So I'm going to fire up the software now. The software is called QLC Plus. And there again is a link to this in the description. So to do what basically I'm about to do, and everything that comes after this, you'll need at least one light that's DMX capable. One of these is a good source. You'll need the connector, this one here, to connect it into the USB on your computer or your laptop or whatever. And I'm using Windows. If you use Linux or Apple stuff, sorry, I can't help you. This is purely a Microsoft Windows-based affair. But if you've got those things and the software installed, then I'll show you on the next bit now how we can control this. So let's fire up the software. So I've got my single light here connected through the connector, the DMX, plugged into USB. And I've opened up the program, the Q-Light Controller Plus, QLC, here it is. So this is what you'd see when you first get it. And there's nothing in there because it doesn't know anything yet about our setup. So we've got to do one important thing, and that's tell us that we're using this particular USB connection. So down on the bottom here, it's got inputs and outputs. We'll click on that. And it might have a different name on yours, depending on how it's been put together at Amazon. But this here, this DMX USB, FT232R USB UART, as a serial number, that is the controller that we've got plugged in. And we just tick output there. And that tells the program that's the output that we want to use to control our lights. So yours might look something different, but it's generally always going to say DMX USB, probably USB UART, and it might have a different number, depends. So they might still be using this exactly as it is. But that's all we need to do there. We also then need to do something on the light itself. So we talked about DMX channels. The DMX channels are numbered 1 to 512. And this light actually has 7 channels. You'll see what they are in a minute. So what we need to do is we need to tell it what its address is. And the address is the number of the first channel. So let me turn my light off so you can see this better. So you can see we've kind of got a little menu on here. At the moment it says RB01. That's just its color cycling thing. But if I press one of these buttons, there you got PLO1. I don't know what that means. Probably pulsing different colors. So these are all the settings you can use if you're going to be like a DJ and just set it up. You can do like flashing, sound to light. There's the red, green, and blue settings. But this is the interesting one. Now, in my case, it's D70. And so that is the address. Now, you can change the address with the buttons here. I can change that down to... Sorry, hard to keep it on camera. But I can change that down to... I'm going to just change it down to number 1. Oh, I've gone past. I've gone 512. There we are. So address number 1, press enter, which I think is that one. And now it's set to address number 1. So what that means is that the 7 different channels, or the 7 different controls that this has, 7 different faders, if you like, on your desk, are numbered 1 to 7. If we'd set it to 10, then they'd be 10 to 17. If we'd left it on 70, they would have been 70 up to 77. So we've set it to 1. And we now need to add, so what these are referred to as fixtures. All your lights, all the things you're going to control are referred to as fixtures. So we need to add this fixture to the software so it knows that it's got one of these connected. So in the fixtures setting here, I didn't need to double click that. We can do an add, and this window will come up. And very conveniently in this software, there is a, these are all different manufacturers' models of lights. Some very, very well known, which means you can just choose what you've got and it will set up all the channels for you. By which I mean, if we choose UK King category there, UK King, there's a light here called the PAR 36. That happens to be perfect for these Amazon lights. It's exactly the right settings. We've got address number one here, which is what we set. There's the seven channels, and you can see what they are. There's a master dimmer, there's red, green, and blue, there's a strobe function, there's a mode function, and there's color selection. The last two, generally, I wouldn't use. They're there for if you want to set it to do a particular pattern, like the going between all the colors, that's like mode. But six and seven are pretty much useless. The red, green, and blue is where it's at, and the master dimmer. But anyway, this is automatic. It's done for us. So we just say, yes, it's a UK King PAR 36. We've set it to address number one. We've got one of them. We just press OK. And there you'll see it in the list. Now, how do we control it from there? All I'm going to do is I'm going to come over to Simple Desk. Now, this program is amazing. You can make your own virtual lighting desk. We will get to that in future parts. This is a multi-part series. I don't want to go on too long, so we'll just cover the basics for now. But if you can see, it's added in here. These wouldn't have been here before. It's got this little bulb there. That's the dimmer. You can see the red, green, and blue. I'm sorry if it's a bit small on your screen there. But, you know, if you really want to be using a PC for this anyway. So watch this on PC, and you should be able to see it. So if I take my dimmer, fade it, and move it all the way up, nothing happens yet. But then if I take the red, you see just at the bottom here, the red LEDs have started to come on. And as I increase the level of red, I get more and more and more intense red until I'm now fully red. If I quickly show you that on the wall there, you can see, look at that. That's fully beautiful red there. If I then decide to increase the green as well, let's bring the red down first. Let's go through it bit by bit. There we go. Red's coming down. I'm now going to introduce the green element. There we go. So now we have a green wash on our wall. Bring that down. We go for the blue. And of course, with red, green, and blue, we can mix the colors together. So if I put some blue in and some red, then I'm going to start to get a purple hue. If I take the blue out and bring the green in, then they get yellow and orange. Like I say, it's not fantastic colors on these because they're very basic devices. But there we go. There's all red and green to give us a yellow. We put all on and we get close to as we can for white. Although it does look more blue than white. But again, that's to do with color balance on the camera. And you can tweak. You know, you can tweak. Or we can bring our dimmer down. Bring our dimmer up. And we can look at some of these other controls. We have a strobe for a strobe control here, as it called it. I think called it strobe. If I bring that up, it strobes the lights. So flashing light warning for anyone there. If I put it to the red and we hit the strobe, we turn that up. There it goes, strobing the red. And it's hard to see on the camera because of the camera shutter. If I bring that down, what have we got here? These modes. There we go. Depending on where you set these, you get different effects. So it's a very, very simple device. Like I say, mode 6 and 7, those channels ignore, because all you want to do really is set red, blue, and green like this. And then we can see with everything up, All the channels are lit, so everything is on full, and that's where you get your sort of nearest color to white output. And so that's a very simple demonstration of how this software is controlling this light. Now, if we wanted to add another light to this, we could daisy chain, like I say, another DMX cable into a second light, so that we could have two lights, and we could make them the same color. You'd get another set of controls for the second light, or we could make them different colors. Or we can do what we call scenes, where I can just press a button and it will go to a preset sort of range of settings. Or there's lots and lots of wonderful things that you can do with these sort of setups. But this was just an introductory video to show you. And if you want to start doing this, if you're a streamer, Jimmy Riddle Show, you might want to dabble in this. You can get four of these lights for about £80 to £100 on Amazon. Four of these lights is enough to illuminate, I'd say, a 1.5 meter back wall. And you can always add more in. But on across that back wall, then you have full control of the colors. You can do all the fancy flashing and things that I do on my stream and everything else. You just need to go ahead and purchase this USB to DMX cable. And you need to download this software, which is absolutely free, costs nothing, and it's brilliant. The things we'll be able to do with this. This might not have been exciting for the first Lammy Learns, but let me tell you now, if you get to this stage where you've got a light that you're able to control with this software, and you haven't spent a lot of money, let's be honest, the potential is limitless. The things you can do, which if you see the live show, you'll get an example of the things you can do. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly pop through a couple of examples of the live show, and I'm just going to put some things on the screen to show you what lights are doing what and how the software is working, to give you some example. But if you're interested in this, keep coming back. We'll do part two. In part two, we'll set up two or three lights. I will show you how to, instead of having to do this to change the colors, etc., I will show you how to put that on one single click button. And I will also show you how to make the two lights flash and dance and do a few other things as well. So that'll be coming in part two. I'm trying to keep these short but sweet, but we'll try and keep them regular as well. So there we go. This is how to control these cheap Amazon RGB Parcan lights with a DMX USB controller into our PC. Trust me, if you do this, you'll get excited by it eventually. When you get the moving heads flying around and everything else, it's really, really cool. You can control smoke machines. It's fantastic. DMX is a wonderful system and really available at a low price. So there we go. Have a look in the description for all you need. And I'll see you on the next one. Come watch the live show on Monday at 7 p.m. Thank you very much. Peace. Lamb out.